Welcome to Tekzilla Bites, feeding your tech hunger fast. I'm Patrick Norton, and I am here to help you deal with the scourge that is iMessage. Okay, iMessage is pretty cool if you're still running an iPhone. It's been out since iOS 5, and it rocks free Wi-Fi texting between iPhones, iPads, iPod Touches, or Macs with iMessage installed. Okay, back in 2011, when iOS 5 hit the streets, unlimited text messages for free was a dream and not part of everybody's contract, but being able to text back your friends without looking up from the screen on your OS 10 machine is still pretty nice. The problem is when iMessage won't let go of your phone number after you've left the iPhone for an Android or Windows phone, and you stop getting text messages. Okay, in theory, you just tap Settings, Messages, and turn iMessages off before you transfer the SIM card into your new non-iOS phone, and a few hours later, you should be getting SMS messages, and your friends with iPhones should be getting green bubbles around your text instead of the blue ones that stand for iMessage. For several friends and I, that didn't work. We figured this out when people called or emailed us to ask why the hell we weren't texting back. Cost my friend a freelance job, cost me a chance to meet with a buddy who's never in town. You get the idea. If you drop the iPhone and iMessage isn't off, you won't get text or SMS messages from folks still on iMessage. What can you do? We'll talk about that in a moment. First, let's talk about what doesn't work to turn off iMessage. According to support.apple.com's can't receive text messages on a non-Apple phone, these steps will not deregister your phone number with iMessage. 1. Logging into My Support profile and changing your password or removing your phone number. 2. Texting stop to 48369. 3. Resetting your network settings. 4. Changing your Apple ID password. The first two certainly didn't work for me, but I did finally get off iMessage so I could get all the text messages again. I'll tell you about that after I tell you about dollarshaveclub.com/Tekzilla. They're a sponsor, and for a few bucks a month, Dollar Shave Club brings great razors right to your door. The blades are solid, they cost a fraction of what the big shave companies want to charge you, and you know what? They work really well. Do your face and your wallet a favor, dollarshaveclub.com/Tekzilla. Now, iMessage. In theory, you can put your SIM card back in your old iPhone. Make sure that you're connected to the cellular data network, tap Settings, Messages, turn iMessage off, and this didn't work for me the first time or the second time, and then my old iPhone gacked 3 times and died completely, so I couldn't try it a third time. I thought I was hosed, but there is hope. It just requires dialing 1-800-275-2273 and spending quality time on hold with Apple's tech support. You can try support.apple.com, but you'll hit a brick wall if you don't have the serial number for your old iPhone. So I called 1-800-275-2273 and get my hold on. And of course, the first thing they asked me for is the IMEI or the serial number for my dead phone. This time I thought I was completely doomed, but Apple decided they could use my phone number and the email address associated with iMessage, and after 10 or so minutes of tech support, sprinkled in with 20 or so minutes of waiting on hold, call it 2943 total, not counting the first time I called when Apple's hold music hung up on me, in which case it would be like 3757, not that I was actually looking at the clock on the phone. By the way, Apple, for a company that prides itself on audio, your hold music is painful. It's compressed like 64K MP3 files from 1998. It's also really loud. It was calling me maybe wasn't helping either, but man, it shouldn't hurt your ears to wait on hold. So yeah, iMessage. The super patient tech support person from Apple that was lucky enough to score my call was able to beat iMessage into submission. And I'm now getting texts and SMS messages from people that thought I was being a jerk and ignoring them. So remember, before you pull the SIM card out of your iPhone and go rogue on Android or Windows or some other operating system on your phone, tap Settings, Messages, and turn iMessage off. And when that doesn't work, call Apple tech support. Want to see the $200 4G LTE Android phone I left my old iPhone 4S for? Check out our review of Motorola's Moto G, and we've got tons of cool Android and iOS app reviews on Tekzilla and Tekzilla Bytes. Tekzilla.com or youtube.com/Tekzilla. Please go subscribe right now. And hey, I'm Patrick Norton. Thank you so much for watching this episode of Tekzilla Bytes.